Hey guys, it's me, Julia Valles, and I am a tutor at Parkland Middle School. And today I am going to review on how to graph in slope-intercept form. So today I'm gonna have a special friend, a little mini me, helping me with today's explanation. So let's get started. Okay guys, so this is my little friend. She's gonna help me explain graphing with slope-intercept form. And we are gonna start off today with a positive slope, but later we're gonna move on to the negative. So things to remember: when a slope is negative, that means that the line will be decreasing. And when the slope is positive, that means that the line will be going up, so increasing. So the first example we see is with a slope that is positive, and the second example is a slope that is negative. And you can determine whether slope is positive or negative, or the line is going up or going down, by the slope being negative or positive. Also, we have to remember that if a slope is 0, then we have a horizontal line. And if the slope is 1 over 0, then we will have a vertical line. And we will have to do the vertical line test to see if any of the numbers repeat themselves. That's very, very important. So what is slope-intercept form? It is when we are given a linear equation that the slope and the y-intercept are already given to us. So we have to remember our formula, which is y equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. So our first example is going to be y equals 2x plus 3. So now let's work on the example. So our slope is 2 and our y-intercept is 3. So the slope is rise over run, always, always. So our slope is 2 over 1, so we're going to go up 2 and to the right 1. And our y-intercept is 0, 3, so the x value is 0 and the y value is 3. So then now this information is given to us, so we can move on to graphing it. So now our y-intercept is 3, so we're going to place a dot on 0 to 3. And our slope is rise over run, and it is 2 over 1, so we're going to go up 2 and to the right 1. And we're just going to keep doing this until we have several values on the board. And that's about it. That's all you really have to do. So yay, you did math. Congratulations. So now we're going to move on to another example. And this example is going to be with a negative number instead of a positive number. So the example is y equals negative 3x plus 5, where our slope is negative 3 and our y-intercept is 5. So we have our x value is 0 and our y value is 5. Alright, so then after this, we are going to graph our linear equation. And since it's negative, our slope is negative, we are going to go down 3 instead of going up 3. Because again, if it's negative, we are going to be decreasing the line. So then we graph our point, which is 5 as our y-intercept. And then we go to down 3 and to the right 1. And that gives us our slope, and we continue doing that until we get several functions. So that's it guys, you had a refresher on how to graph with some functions, both negative and positive, and I hope that helped. So thank you to my little friend for helping us out today, and that is all she has for you guys today. So yeah, thanks little friend. Alright guys, that's all for this video. I hope it helped refresh your memory on how to graph with slope-intercept form. You just have to keep a few things in mind. If you have a negative slope, then your line is going down, which means it is decreasing. And if you have a positive slope, then that means your line is the same and it is increasing and going up. Also, you just have to keep a few things in mind. If you have a slope equal to 0, then you have a horizontal line, and if you have a slope that is 1 over 0, then you have a vertical line. You have to do the vertical line test. So I hope this video helped, and make sure if you have any questions to come back and watch this video if it helped you, or to get some help from tutor.com, or ask your teachers, or look up any other videos that might help you. So I hope it helps, and I'll see you guys in the next video.